Islam was gradually introduced to Indonesia by Indian traders from Gujarat in the 16th century. Today, over 85% of Indonesians follow Islam. They practice the religion with a unique spirit of tolerance, true to the mystical heritage of their soil, that teaches that real purity is a matter of a person's inner life. Within the family, each is free to choose his or her own path of faith. And social values are imbibed from the vayang, or shadow plays, of the Ramayana and Mahabharata. In his letters from Java, Tagore says, they have acquired a subtle refuge in India's soul through the epics. So for an Indian visiting Indonesia, it is a thrill to see the Mahabharata heroes, Krishna and Arjun, ride their chariot in the heart of the city of Jakarta. And here, on a full moon night of Prambanan near Yogyakarta in Java, it is Muslim Indonesians who perform the Ramayana.
Sri Ram Malakhananga Prabhajangara Gubaranga Sitapati Sundarang.
Back in India, in the northeastern state of Manipur, the Ramayana unfolds when a storyteller begins the episode of Hanuman Dut, or messenger, alongside the shadow theatre in Orissa and the dance ballet of Prambanan in Indonesia.
Hanuman Kokshalo, Hajra Hanuman Kokshale, Jambubana, Hanumanangi, Biboro, Liba, the Nangase, Amna, you took Jam, Sogani, Aduganame, you took Yanki Shangani, Nankarigma Muniki, Sap, Amanang, say, Amna Pixin, Lady Nangi, Jama Biboro, Lirigi, Sumaira, Hanuman, Jama Biboro, and she lirik. Mana Sara Pose, Utsaker, no Surin, Srikoloma, Keso, Bosenta Kadama Pule, Sodri Sang, Lendon, Badramasi, Indri, Dung, Ibamibo, and Sodri Sang. Okay, Ram Ram, Ram Ram, I just hold it to say, Masina. So much as woman of the Harry, say, go to your pride, send Kumulamakan, my Makapang, Jay Ramana, Kabu, I did not Ramana, Sanman, Yakalam, hey, Han!
Traders cross the ocean carrying cloths from the shores of India to Indonesia and returned with gold and spices as early as the 1st century AD. Since then, with the continuous movement and exchange of goods across the Indian Ocean, there was also a movement and exchange of ideas. Various forms of shadow puppetry evolved in Indonesia, often performed in rituals where the dalang or puppeteer is the high priest.
In ancient Orissa, the Bhat Sampraday community of shadow puppet performers were patronized by the kings of Puri. They accompanied the merchants on their trading ships. This is how they earned their livelihood, sailing away for several months.
Textile traditions of both countries have interacted and enriched each other with new colors, new designs, and mystical symbols. Marana Vanyato, Katindraga Marana. In India and Indonesia, textiles are much more than just cloths from which garments are made. They are a medium through which the divine nature of the universe is recognized and expressed. The eye sees, the heart feels, the senses resound. The entire being vibrates with the essence, the rasa of life. Feeling the thread of the divine song, the dancer weaves exquisite patterns of the universe into a web of magic. Ancient Indian scriptures list 9 dramatic emotions or navras depicted through stylized facial expressions. The Manipuri people of India bear a remarkable similarity to the Indonesians, perhaps due to a common ethnicity. Dance in Manipur is as graceful, gentle, and meditative as its Javanese counterpart. Our rites of passage give each life a sacred significance. Rituals ensure protection and continuity, while harmony within family and community ensures an undisturbed inner life.
Ahanbada ekoina Vishnu ki puja hana taui adugi mathangda ekoina angangbu kuchat manga ka loina na amamam ta taroga angang sibu pijai ahanbada ko puja taroga anda angang sibu tekta kaidna ba mahaki punchinung shangna ba hana ishoda thongi jai
Manipur and Bali are culturally dynamic, adopting, adapting, and refining outside influence as seen in their practice of Hinduism. In Bali, the maturation ceremony is done through tooth filing of the upper canine to symbolize the taming of passions. Wow. The puppeteer priest or Dalang continues the Hanuman story through the tooth filing ritual. And in Orissa, Guru Sahu's Ravan Chaya troupe performs for their audience.
বর্তমান হনুমান ধেনুমানক সহিত লঙ্কাগড়কু প্রবেশ করছন্তি.
And also in Orissa, with the daily prayers to Jagannath or Krishna, are daily rehearsals of the young Gotipua dancers. With Orissa existed from the pre-Buddhist times. Even today in Indonesia, the word kling is used to describe people of Indian origin, perhaps referring to Kalinga, the ancient Orissa. And in Orissa, even today, people celebrate the Bali Jatra in memory of the age-old journeys to Bali.
Iya, Nya. Saya takut di sini. Si Jali itu jahat ya sama Neng. Lu harus sabar. Emang anak itu kayak bapaknya. Sombong, kasar, kurang diajar. Neng harus sabar.
In Tengganan, Bali, the god Indra is honored as the divine designer of a magical fabric called geringsing, a double ikat textile, where resist patterns are applied to the warp and the weft, and the final pattern appears on completion of the weaving. A technique practiced in the patola saris of Gujarat and the bandhas of Orissa. In Indonesia and India, continuity is essential. An unbroken chain of designs and ideas passed down from one generation to the next and holding the power within. The idea of continuity is held in the mandala patterns that represent the cosmos, and the symbol gives power to the cloth. It is used to protect during rites of passage. We live in a world filled with uncertainties where change is constantly necessary. The idea of no or slow change brings a sense of yearning. Objects that are part of this slow evolution connect us with something that is missing in our lives. The yarn is dyed prior to weaving, according to a predetermined color scheme and design. The dye bleeds into the tied areas, which gives the ikat fabric its distinctive blurred or fuzzy-edged look. In Orissa, the weavers take great pains to create the curved line for a fluid, lyrical quality. The mandala symbol is a geometric construct representing the cosmos as a continuum and is found in the textiles and dance traditions of India and Indonesia. While the mandala demonstrates the time-space continuum of the cosmos, the black and white checks reconcile the forces of opposites, negative and positive. Contained within them are day and night, light and darkness. Both have equal status. Both are inherent in reality. In keeping with this duality of purposes, Balinese dancers adopt the dvibhanga, or two bends, also a basic classical Indian stance. The curved line, the circle form of mandala, and the entwined figure 8 suggests a philosophy, a holistic worldview that rests on the belief that time is a continuum. It is eternal. The entwined lines represent the serpentine flow of the prana, or force of life, rising upward as two forces, the negative and positive. They appear in the kolam designs of Kerala and again in the ground patterns of the dancers of the Lai Harauba dance ritual of Manipur. The deity of the ritual is believed to manifest as a snake. The two parts for the flow of the life force that exists within each one of us are called the Ingal and Pingal Nadis in yogic science of Kundalini. The traditional disciplines of dance, yoga, and martial arts are based on this science. Their purpose is holistic, and their forms are designed to energize, heal, and purify us by aligning us with the cosmic forces.
Thank you.
The force of gravity works on every piece of earth, but not equally. In Indonesia, the stress is acute. Tidal energy concentrates there to such a degree that it must be dissipated in volcanic activity, or giant waves like the tsunami. Movements arise like sparks out of fire, showing the temperament of their land. It is instruction by the body. The pupil wears the teacher's skin, fitting herself precisely to the mold of her mentor. The teacher carries a whole percussion section on his tongue, shaping the girl's body, making it remember. Classical dance and yoga depict the secret science of Kundalini Shakti as she awakens and rises from the base of the spine to meet the beloved in Sahasrara or cranial region for yoga or union. I am the nature of nature. My song is of the wind and rain and sun and hail. And like the seasons and their certain strengths of death and rebirth and all the nuances of color and shape, so am I.
Jump, 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 jump.
fire was sought not because it is useful, but because it fascinates. We have captured the spirit of the sun. We glow, we dance, we are inflamed. Nature bursts to the full. Pran or vitality is imbibed from her elements. Her elemental power is sought in artistic expression.
Jungle and the natural environment. Sometime when we go to the cave, suddenly only a small space, and then we become more true to ourselves. As a dancer, classical Asian court dancer usually have too much. He inherited too much, too rich. Sometimes it has become a burden also for his soul, because we tend to enjoy a lot of that kind of spectacular form. Sometimes we were absorbed into that kind of power, stage power. Sometimes when we go to the cave, we become more aware of the body, not the dancer's body, not the patronized body, but just the body itself.
Built in the 10th century, the Prambanan temple complex in Yogyakarta has Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva temples. The monument commemorates 16 centuries of Hindu culture in the Indonesian archipelago. There are 42 panels dedicated to the Ramayana, and the Grand Ramayana Ballet is staged within this complex. old Javanese text called Navanatya mentions karanas or dance friezes. These karanas of Prambanan precede the ones found in India by at least 100 years. Once again, through a medley of Indonesian and Indian forms, is the story of Hanuman in Lanka, who finds the captive Sita in Ashokvan. And so, the story climaxes with Hanuman setting fire to Lanka. Our past is as multidimensional and richly woven as our tapestries. A cross-section of our histories shows matching layers of animism, Hinduism, Islam, and colonial eras all coexisting today. But through all the change and diversity, both nations have upheld a tradition of reverence and grace.